Welcome back to 5 Steps to Freedom Forever, the Holy Marriage Blessing. I'm Tyler Hendricks. This is the second part of the explanation of the 3-day ceremony. What's the meaning of 3 days? Israel had 3 days to escape Egypt. They had 3 days to enter the Promised Land. Jesus spent 3 days to resurrect from the grave. We have 3 days to start our eternal marriage. The prophecy of the second coming in Revelation explains what happens in the 3 days. The bride descends from above to meet the bridegroom who is below. This happens not just once, twice at the end of Revelation. And this is the model for the first 2 days of the 3-day ceremony. After the bride comes down twice, the Lamb of God dwells in the center of the city. This is the model for the 3rd day. So God teaches us even more about this 3-day ceremony through the story of Noah and the dove. After the flood judgment, Noah and his wife entered a world that was washed from evil. Noah released a dove to see whether the earth was ready to receive him and his wife, who were like the new Adam and Eve, like the Messiah and his bride. On the 1st and 2nd day, the dove returned. On the first flight, the dove returned with no sign of life. There was no place for God's word and spirit to land upon the earth. This represented Adam, by whose fall the word could not land on earth, but returned to God. So in the 1st day of the 3-day ceremony, we have the first flight of the dove. By his going into her womb, the bride, as the mother, gives her husband rebirth as a restored Adam, an immature son. On the 2nd flight, the dove returned with an olive branch. This represented Jesus. By the crucifixion, the word returned to God with the olive branch of Jesus' forgiving love. On the 2nd day of the 3-day ceremony, by his going into her womb, the bride as mother gives her husband rebirth as a restored Jesus. Jesus was the prepared bridegroom, a man who is prepared to receive the bride and be her husband. On the 3rd flight, the dove did not return. It means God's ideal found its dwelling place in the new heaven and new earth. Noah and his wife, the new Adam and Eve, could descend to the earth from the ark. This represents the 3rd day of the 3-day ceremony, with us as the new Adam and Eve. The husband is reborn as the bridegroom who receives his true bride from God. In the position of the Lord, he gives rebirth to his wife as his bride without stain or blemish. They together inherit the perfection of love, free from sin, as God designed in the Garden of Eden. The 3-day ceremony begins each day with an individual washing of their sexual organ with a cloth infused with holy wine. Husband and wife then bow to God and each other, pray, disrobe, enter upon and complete the holy act of love, bow, and close in prayer. On the 1st day, the wife gives birthing love, positioned above, with her husband below. She births him as the new Adam. On the 2nd day, the wife gives birthing love, again above, with her husband below. She births him as the new Jesus. On the 3rd day, the husband, in the position of Jesus, God's only begotten Son, positioned above, gives birth to his wife, positioned below, as a new Eve. This is the completion. The gate to God's direct dominion is opened, in which husband and wife are governed by God's love alone. After the 3 days, naked and not ashamed, God, husband and wife, say, "It is very good." The curse upon marriage is removed forever. The Holy Marriage Blessing is complete. And God's dominion over your marriage, the dominion of truth, beauty, and goodness is yours forever. May God bless your couple. Thank you for listening.